defender of Castle Grayskull, Eternia, as well as the entire universe. He is better known as He-Man, the most powerful man in the universe, known as the evil lord of destruction, set to terrorize and rule Eternia, as well as in capturing all the secrets and the powers of Grayskull, even the entire universe. He is known as Skeletor. Masterverse Revelations, He-Man and Skeletor, up next on Tease Multiverse. Welcome to Tease Multiverse, folks. I'm your host, Tyrus, and I have the power! Because I've been waiting to do these for some time now. They've been sitting, man, and I've been looking to do these figures. You know, I had them ever since maybe a week or two before part one dropped. So I've had them in my cache for some time. If you're new to this channel or don't know, I am one of the biggest He-Man fans that you'll find out there. You know, I love He-Man. He was the first character that I fell into as a kid. He was the first character that first figure collection that I had as a kid. So I really have a strong connection and a love for the He-Man character. Love the 80s animated series. The 2000X cartoon is hands down for me the best animated series for the He-Man character. And then the Masterverse Netflix series, not my cup of tea at all. Hopefully part two will be better. I know we got part two coming. It's just around the corner. So hopefully part two will be better. Who knows? We'll see. That's a whole nother story. But even though I don't care for the Netflix series, it definitely doesn't take away my love for this Masterverse line. I am extremely impressed with what they've done with this Masterverse line. I think it's phenomenal. I love the scaling, the detail of the figures. That Battle Cat is honestly the best Battle Cat I've ever seen. I love what we're getting down the road with this Masterverse line. What we're getting right now, I mean, there's a Man-at-Arms. We got Spikor, whose review is coming up. I do have Spikor, Fisto, King Grayskull. I mean, there's a lot to look forward to within this line. So to have these two figures to review is a treat for me as a big He-Man fan. I never reviewed the Origins figures. So I was like, there is no way in the world I could move on without reviewing He-Man and Skeletor. There's just no way. So here we are. We're going to look at these characters here. We're going to examine the box first. So here we have this old school style display packaging of the Masterverse figures here. I like the fact that he had the old UPC up here. Through our display window here, we're treated to a view of our figures here, as well as the accessories that are included. Here we have Netflix on the side. Here we have Masterverse Revelation He-Man, as well as Masterverse up top, of course. Here we have He-Man, the most powerful man in the universe. Again, over here with Skeletor, we got Skeletor, Masters of the Universe Revelation. Here on the side, Skeletor, Evil Lord of Destruction. And on the side here, we're treated to this wonderful art of these two characters here. Man, this just looks beautiful, man. This artist is just, he's absolutely phenomenal. I cannot think of his name right now, but this guy is amazing. And on the back, we have even larger promo images of our characters here, as well as the bios. Man, this looks absolutely magnificent. Here we also are treated to some other characters that are within this wave as well. We have Mossman and Evil Lyn. All right, so now that we've checked out the packaging, let's get these two out of the box. All right, so first up is, guess who? The most powerful man in the universe, He-Man. You got to go up He-Man. This is my guy right here. All right, so we have He-Man. He comes with a few accessories. First and foremost, let's check out this sword here. I mentioned this during, if you haven't checked out my Scareglow review, definitely check that out. I have a link in the description below, but I said that then, and I'm gonna say it now, man, the attention to detail and sculpting that's placed within the power sword, this is the best sculpted He-Man sword that I've seen from the Masterverse line. Skele-God had this sword. Man, this looks absolutely amazing. I really love the sculpting all the way down here to the end here where he holds the sword. He has the little brown, you know, wooden wrap here around the end here. So as a He-Man fan, to have a detailed sword such as this is a huge plus for me. All right, so we're going to check out his shield. I don't use a shield for my He-Man character. Never have and never will be. Always love the design though. And that orange and gray color just takes me back to the 80s as a kid when I had the He-Man figure. So always when I see the shield, it just takes me back to that. Even though I never used the shield, I always see it used on promo and promo images or whatnot, but I just never cared to use a shield. So, but I'll add this to the collection. Maybe I haven't used it at some point. You know, who knows? We'll see. But here we also have two hands to swap out for him. So we have these two grabbing hands. All right, so let's take a look at He-Man, the most powerful man in the universe. Now I know when initial images was released of this guy, many, including myself, was not too thrilled with this face sculpting. I really felt that it left a lot to be desired. I wanted maybe a more battle-driven face sculpt, or maybe just a separate swappable head. Because this one, you know, as I'm looking at it, and even through time, I've had this figure in package for some time now. It's grown on me, you know. I mean, I get it. I get where they were going with this face sculpt. It has that little smirky, I'm gonna get you type look, maybe, you know. So it doesn't look bad at all. I like it now. It's like I said, it has grown on me. But it would have been cool if they would have added a second swappable head, more of a battle driven, more seriouser sculpted head that we've had, that we could have had. Maybe they'll do another He-Man figure with that. Who knows? You know, we'll see. But overall, it's definitely growing on me. Here, I'm gonna put it closer to the camera. We can see some detail within the hair. They've added splashes and little shades of darkness within his blonde hair to give it some depth or whatever. So that looks pretty solid. I like that. And I think this pulls up. Yep, so this is a different piece. So this pulls up so you can see his ears or whatnot. So that's pretty cool. So this is a whole separate piece. So this is nice, man. I like that. And then here you can see there's a difference in the shading and the texture from his chest area and his face. So that's pretty interesting as well. I love this gauntlet, man. This is awesome. Now, one of the designs that I noticed from the Masterverse, you know, trailer one was this gauntlet, man, or the images that was released for the series before that trailer one drop was this gauntlet. I like this. I like stuff like this. I was hoping to see in part one, that he would transform this maybe into a shield. Because I think he did that in the 2000X series, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, he did, when he had the snake costume. So I'm hoping, maybe we might still see that. But I always thought that if he had a gauntlet like this, that it would be a workable gauntlet to where it would transform into some sort of a shield. So hopefully, maybe that might be the case. Who knows? We'll see. But I like that. I like that design. They actually nailed that. You have the little loincloth, the little darker shaded loincloth, which looks good. The sculpting here of the muscles and everything. This is a solid figure, and he stands without any problems at all. I'm not going to need some sort of a stand, like figure stand for this guy, because he's really sturdy. And here he has the little muscle detail throughout. Really looks good. Here we have little back here. He looks really solid here. The detail muscles throughout really looks pretty cool. He doesn't have a sheath for his sword. I don't like that. I really wish they would have added that so that you can put his sword. But I think you can just slide it through the back here. Yeah, but I really wish they would have added maybe a sheath thing that you can just slide the sword through. That would have been pretty cool. But really like this. Here the detailing throughout looks really solid here. And here we have the little boots. Shading for the boots looks really cool. Really like that. Solid looking figure. Let's check out his articulation here. So he has, let's see, he can look up pretty well. And let's sit down. He can go from side to side here, no problem. All the way around. I'm liking this He-Man figure. Let's check his little arm rotation here. So you can go all the way around, no problem there. He has bicep swivel, which is really impressive there. Elbows go in and out pretty easy. So no problem with the elbows. The wrist rotation. Oh, wrist fell off. So snap that back on. But wrist goes around pretty well, even though it snapped out. Go up and down. And then let's check out his let's check out his app. So upper torso. So upper torso articulation works pretty well. Up and down, we have some rocking here, which is pretty solid. And then it can go, can it go all the way around? Nope. Well, can't go all the way around. It can go from side to side, rocks this like this. Now he does have waist swivel. Now that goes all the way around, no problem at all. So that's pretty cool. And then his leg, he has this, oh, he has thigh, upper thigh rotation here, which is really cool. I'm telling you, these Masterverse figures are impressive. The articulation, the sculpting, the scale. I think they scale taller than the Master of the Universe classic figures. So, yeah, I'm impressed with this Masterverse line. I don't think he can do the splits. Yeah, I don't think he can split or anything. Well, yes, he can. Oh, yes, he can. Oh, man. All right. Prove me wrong, He-Man. There you go. He said, man, I can do that. I can split. There you go. So, yeah, he's just cool. All right. And then he has nice knee articulation. He can go. He's just tight, but he can go all the way back like that. So that's cool. He-Man also has boot swivel as well. So that works really cool. And then he has awesome articulation here in the ankle area, which goes down, up, no problem. And he also has some rocking. Let's swap out. Do I want to swap out a hand? Let's swap out a hand. Let's just swap something out. So, let's get him to punch first. Mama said, knock you out. Brah. I had to do that. I just had to do it. All right. So, there we go. Yeah, this is cool, man. I like that. All right. So we're going to. Oh, yeah. I need to swap this out because he needs to hold his sword. Oh, yeah. All right. We're going to equip us a shield for this review. There we go. All right. All right, let's close out this segment. You got to have him holding his power sword aloft. There we go. By the power of Grayskull. All right, on to the, I'm having fun with these, boys. I'm having fun with these, all right. All right, up next is the evil warlord of destruction, the man, the myth, the legend, Skeletor. And he comes with a few accessories, really cool accessories. So, of course, he comes with his Havoc staff here, which looks really good, sculpted really well. I love the hue of dark and lavender purples. And I feel it's just grays that they utilize with this Havoc staff. Really like that design. So solid. That's one of the accessories that really jumped out to me when I saw this figure was, I was like, man, this Havoc staff looks really awesome. So really impressed with the Havoc staff for this Skeletor figure. And then he comes with this, some sort of a magical scepter. I cannot remember the name of this because he used it in the original series and I saw it in the Masterverse, you know, I think part one as well. I just can't remember exactly what this is called. Let me know in the comments, folks, if you know what this weapon is. So, not sure exactly, but it really looks cool. I like design. I love the color for this one. Really simple, sleek design for this magical artifact. Here, we're treated to some additional hands to swap out here for our Skeletor. This is like he's kind of getting ready to point or something. I'm not sure. And then he has like an open hand here. So we'll just swap those out later on to just see how they look on Mr. Skeletor. And then let's pull Skeletor closer. Now his face sculpt looks amazing. I know I've heard people say that they didn't like the coloring, but I love it. I think it's different. And I always like something different than what I have. You know, I have Skeletors that have just the yellow face skull covering color. But I like that, just that really, you know, bland. It's barely, it's like a hint of green, maybe a super washed out yellow or whatnot. But man, I really like that. Now, granted, you know, if you color this yellow, it will make this maybe pop maybe a little better. Who knows? I might do it, but I like it like this. Honestly, I take it back. I like it like this. I mean, I like that little bland color that they have for the skull, it's just different, and I really like that. He looks a little bit more menacing, I feel, this way. So I really like the look that they chose for this and the color palette that they chose for the skull. You know, the little grin really looks cool. Very, very, very menacing. You know, the eyes here, I really like that. Again, what they could have done is given us a separate head swap for the Skeletor. You know, maybe the pupils, maybe one with the yellow pupils or red pupils showing or whatnot. Something to showcase, like, maybe energy that's emitting from his eyes or whatnot. That would have been pretty cool. But all in all, really solid head sculpt. Really like what they've done. Again, love the color palette that they utilized for this Skeletor all the way through. We have a series of blues and lavender, dark and light lavenders throughout. I really like that. Black here in certain areas. So, and I love soft good capes. So I really like that. I like that with the Scareglow, you know, Comic Con figure. And I like they utilize a soft goods cape for the Skele-God as well. So I really like that. Would have liked it better if they would have maybe given us a torn tethered cape for Skeletor. I don't think Skeletor would have just a really clean, you know, cape with no rips or no torn. Or maybe like give us that Batman type cape with the little, you know, designs in it throughout. Love the design for the classic little skull, you know, chest plate here that we have here. The little bat design we can see sculpted within his harness. Really looks good. The details throughout his physique really translate well with this figure. Really like that. You know, we have the loincloth. It's like a soft goods plastic, which really works well. And yeah, really looks solid. Here we have a little detail here and a little boot area, or half boot, because, you know, as he's showing his feet right here. So let's check out his articulation here. So he can look up, no problem. Down, no problem at all. He can go from side to side. He can go down. I'll get you, He-Man. So arm articulation here. Let's check this out. This little harness piece on the shoulders is getting in the way a bit, but he still has pretty much the same articulation as He-Man. And so this goes round, no problem. You know. And then we have bicep swivel here up here. The elbow articulation works just as well as the He-Man. So no problem with that. He has good wrist articulation. Can go around, can go in and out. And then we're gonna check out his upper torso articulation here. Let me get his arm straightened out here. So of course he has some rocking here in the upper torso. So that goes really well. He can go from side to side like that. He does have waist swivel, which goes all the way around with no problem. Again, like He-Man, he does have that upper thigh rotation here, and he can do, let's see if he can do the splits. Can he pass the splits test? Move his weapons out of the way, and he can. Skeletor said I can do it too. He can do the splits. All right, cool. And then let's check out his knee articulation. He can go all the way back. Skeletor also has some boot swivel. So that's pretty cool. Really solid. And then the ankle articulation, this big old foot here, can go up, down with no problem. And he also has a little bit of a rocking as well. So really solid articulation for Skeletor. And let's swap out his hands here. So I'll place his magical staff in his hand here. So I'm gonna swap out. Slides in really well. All right, so I'm going to close this out by equipping Skeletor with his Havoc Staff as well as his other magical artifact here. And we got him posed. Got double the trouble. All right, look out, universe. Somebody go get He-Man. You know what time it is. It's comparison time. So, along with my Masterverse Revelations He-Man and Skeletor, I have my Masters of the Universe Origins He-Man and Skeletor. So, He-Man meet He-Man, Skeletor meet Skeletor. The best of both worlds here I have. And here we have more figures from that fantastic origin line with Prince Adam, as well as my Battle Damage He-Man. Wow. So talk about best of the best right here. So along with my Masterverse figures, I have my Classics Club Grayskull Super 7 He-Man, Skeletor, as well as Stratos, who are all direct representations of the 80s Filmation series. Three of the most phenomenal figures within my He-Man collection, hands down. And here we have more figures from my Masterverse collection, starting with He-Man's most trusted sidekick with the heroic Battle Cat. Then we have Moss Man and Evil Lyn, Skele-God, and the San Diego Comic-Con exclusive Scarecrow figure. If you haven't checked out my review on this guy, definitely do so. I have a link in the description below. But as I mentioned before, I am so impressed with this line. I am excited for what they have coming, and I definitely look forward to what they will be coming up with as they continue to dive into the He-Man lore. So we got some exciting times, I feel, down the road with this Masterverse line. Well, it seems like we're in for yet another one of those classic battles between both He-Man and Skeletor. But folks, I want to thank you all for tuning in. I hope you enjoyed the review. And for those of you who hadn't subscribed to the channel, I'd like to ask you to subscribe to the channel. I'd love for you to join Team Multiverse. Hit that like button. It would really help push the channel forward. Smash that bell notification so that you're notified when my videos drop. And if you did all that, I really appreciate it. And until next time, folks, be good to one another. Be safe, stay tuned, and remember, I have the power. Until next time, folks, bye for now.